How can you calculate the difference between 2 days in Excel? How can you calculate the number of days and exclude weekends? That's what today's video is about. Now, I know not all weekends are Saturday and Sunday, and your personal non-working days might be a Monday and a Thursday, or Monday to Friday. So let's take a look at how you can count the number of days between 2 days and exclude the days that shouldn't count. Here I have my start dates and my end dates, and first I'm going to calculate the number of days between these 2 dates. That's really simple, just type in equals, go to the cell that has the end date minus the starting date. Because remember, in Excel, dates are actually stored as numbers, so it's very easy to make calculations based on these. I get 12 for this range and 6 for the other range. Now we can cross-check on the calendar here. From the 2nd of June till the 14th of June, we come to 7 here, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right? So that works well. Now notice that the start date isn't counted, but the end date is. Okay, so keep that in mind when you calculate the difference in this way. Now, how about calculating the number of working days between these 2 dates? So we don't want to include weekends, and we ultimately also don't want to include any holidays. So I have the list of holidays written here, and I want to be able to exclude these as well. Well, there is a great formula for this, and it's called the network days formula. Now you're going to see two versions. The second one was included, I think, from Excel 2010 onwards. So you're going to have this one for sure. Now, the reason this was included was to make the original network days function more flexible, because you can pick what type of weekends you have, because not all weekends are Saturdays and Sundays. That's the assumption if you use the network days function. Here you give it a start date and an end date. You cannot define your weekends because by default, it's going to pick Saturdays and Sundays. So the more flexible version of this function is the international version, so INTL. Now, when we open the bracket, we have this extra weekend argument here. So let's go through this. We need the start date, that's this one. We need the end date, that's this one. Now, we can specify our weekends. If your weekends are Saturday and Sunday, you don't need to do anything. You can just close the bracket. If you don't want to include holidays, just close the bracket, press enter, and we get 9 working days between these 2 dates. Now we can quickly check. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So notice I counted the start date as well. So keep this in mind when you use the network days function. It counts both the start date as well as the end date. Now, what if you want to include holidays? So here I'm going to assume that my weekends are still Saturday and Sunday. I'm going to put a 1. You can also skip the argument because the default is Saturday and Sunday. Now for holidays, my list is here. I'm going to select that. And because I'm planning to pull down my formula, I'm going to fix this range. Now close bracket, press enter, and I get 8 working days between these 2 dates. Now it was 9 before, it became 8 because there is a holiday in between. That's the 3rd of June. Now, if your weekends are different, you just have to pick the right weekend for you. So if I just go back so that we can see the different options we have for weekends, there is a lot here. So if your weekends are, for example, Friday and Saturday, you can go with this one. And then include your holidays if you want. If you don't have holidays, you can exclude it. And you're going to have Friday and Saturday as your weekend. If your weekend is just Sunday, go with 11, and that's the number of working days you need to go with. Okay, so I'm just gonna put this back to 1 here and drag down my formula. Okay, so notice this one is just 3 because 28th and 29th of May are holidays. Now let's get to the most flexible version of this function. There is a trick you can use to define your working days or define which days you want to exclude. Right? Because your weekends might be different. They might be something that's not available on this list. Or you might just work on specific days. In this case, you're just working on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Saturdays. And you want to calculate your working days between these 2 dates. Well, this is what you can do. We're going to go with Network's International version. The start date is this one. The end date is this one. Now we are going to take control over our weekends and we're going to give it a flag of ones and zeros. So you start with quotation marks and then inside here, you have to put 7 ones and zeros. The days you want to exclude will have a 1. The days you want to include will have a 0. And you're going to start from Monday. Okay, so these are the rules. Okay, so here my working days are Mondays. I'm going to go with a 0. Tuesday, a 0. Wednesday, Thursday, I don't work. Friday, I don't work. They're going to get 1s. Saturday, I work. That's a 0. And Sunday, I don't work. It's a 1. Okay, so now we're going to put a quotation mark here. And if we want to exclude holidays, we can continue and reference this range. But just to cross-check that this works, let's close the bracket, press enter. And now I get 5 days between these 2 days if I'm only counting Monday, Tuesday, and Saturday. So let's cross-check. From this week here, I'm only counting Saturday. So that's 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 5 for Monday. Right, so that's correct. It's only counting my working days. Let's just drag this down. Here I get 3 days, 1, 2, and 3. Right, so now what if I want to include holidays? I'm going to add that last argument here for my holidays, plus F4 to fix it. And now I only have 5 working days. And here I should have 1, right? Because there are 2 holiday days in the last week of June. Okay, so remember this trick if you want to have full flexibility on which days you want to include and which ones you want to exclude. If you're curious how I created this calendar, I use the new dynamic array functions that are available in Office 365. That's the function behind this. I even have a video on how you can create a dynamic calendar using these functions in Excel. So check that out on my channel. So that's how you can count the number of days between 2 dates. I hope you found this video useful. I hope you're enjoying the content of my channel, because if you do, please subscribe, stick around, and we can catch up in the next video.